So here we are, Friday the 13th, and it's gosh, almost midnight. And the wife's gone to bed and said, "Keep it down." But I was really getting into this mix tonight, and so I wanted to keep going and video a little bit of it. It's been quite a week of things going on. I had one of the converters that process all the analog information to digital when we made the transfer, and then subsequently, once it's all in digital form, it needs to come back into analog to get back into the board. Anyway, when I finally got all the transfers done last week, I have two of these units in the rack here. I think you can see on my right, and just as I'm about to start mixing Hold Your Back, one of them went down. So I've been just trying to get that sorted for the last few days, and I just want to th say thanks to Don at SSL, who's the VP there, for organizing getting a new unit down to us, and very much appreciate that. And also to my very good friend Richard Dodd for loaning me a piece of gear that he is guarded very closely, a piece of gear that he worked on with Dan Rudin here in Nashville, and it's called the Motone, and it's over here in the rack, and I've just put it in today, and I've got no idea what's inside it. He won't tell me, but there's apart from Richard, who uses it on his mixes and his mastering, and Dan, this is the only other unit that's ever been out anywhere, so I'm very privileged to have this. When I talked to him over the weekend, and when he came for over dinner, I told him what we were doing and remixing the Rockin' All Over the World, he said, "I've just got a great piece of gear for you that you're gonna love for the guitars." And so we got it in today, and all wired up and connected into the board, and it's just a wonderful little piece of additional outboard gear, and it's called the Motone, so I've nicknamed it the Mojo. So we've got a bit of that going on Richard and Francis's guitars, and what else is going on? I think that's about it now. Got the mix up to a reasonable state now, and some of it is already, some of the mutes and everything have already been automated, and some of the moves, but I like to get to a point where I can really start to feel elements of it and ride the mixes in the good old manual way, and get the excitement of going through and getting a pass down, and as we used to do before we had so much of automation to just make it an endless task. I still love the feel of moving the faders and getting the hands on things, and that's why this board exists here, because so many things could be done. Well, this entire process could have been just done inside a computer now, but there's nothing like having a bit of analog going on. And so anyway, that's about it. I'm just going to try and get through a few passes, and I'm going to be using the automation to record what I do. You may be wondering what all these blue bits of tape are, and let me just explain that the back in the 70s, we had faders and we had chinagraph markers, and we used the faders. We used to be have plenty of space to use these chinagraphs, and we used to mark the positions. But I mean, the chinagraph pencil is pretty fat, so it was not that accurate. I remember at the Marquee we had this board called the 400. It was an MCI 400A, and we used to mark on the sides of these faders that were made by a company called API. And you just get a tissue and wipe them off, and then mark it as you're making all your moves. But then we changed the board, and we got a 500. And on the 500, there was a little slider that assigned the groups, and there were various LEDs for the automation, and there was very few places that you could actually write any information on the side of the faders, the points that you wanted to get to on the mix. So I I don't know whether it was unique to me, but I came up with this idea of using strips of masking tape, and my assistants used to their job was to take a razor blade and a clipboard and finally make these little strips up that I used to stick on the side of the fader. But anyway, I'm doing it all myself now. So such as times have changed, and but that's what it is. It allows me to make the fader marks of where I've got the mix and bring the faders down and ride them up to those points and keep the mix output that way as clean as possible. So having said all that, I think we better get on and press play and see what happens. So here it goes.
Yeah, no, but it was a fucking tidy feel. Ooh.
Can we do what? Can we do another one for luck? Because there was
Let's
one
keep
that.
You played.
Classic. All right, let's have an ear roll of that then. Time for a little bit of refreshments. Cashews.